Russian jet spent seconds in Turkish airspace, probably less than 30 seconds. Is it NATO's concern at all that Turkey may have overreacted here?
So all NATO allies support Turkey's right to defend its airspace, its territorial integrity. But again, we are also focused on how can we prevent this kind of incidents to happen again. This was not the first time Turkish airspace was violated. We saw that also in October. But one of the issues we'll discuss when NATO foreign ministers meet tomorrow in Brussels is how can we strengthen military to military lines of communications, mechanisms for de-conflicting to avoid this kind of incidents to happen again.
And Secretary General, speaking of violating airspace, you may have seen this, the Greek Prime Minister accused Turkey of violating Greek airspace. How does NATO react to that?
I think we have to remember that Turkey is in on the front line of a very, very unstable and difficult situation in Syria and Iraq. And of course, for Turkey to be so close on the border of all the fighting, all the killings, and all the military buildup from the Russian side, which we have seen there during the last weeks or months, creates a very special situation. And this was not the first time, it has happened before.
I was actually referring to the Greek Prime Minister accusing Turkey of violating Greek airspace. He did so on Twitter. How does NATO react to that?
I try to explain to you that there are completely different situations.
No, Turkey, I understand that, but there is a violation, bordering, according to Greece, of its airspace by Turkey. So are there two standards here?
No, we underline the importance of respecting the airspace of any nation. But I think we have to understand that Turkey is in a very special situation. They have been bordering Syria, so they are bordering Syria where they have been fighting turmoil for several years. They have seen a substantial Russian military buildup, both in the air, on land, and also now in the eastern part of the Mediterranean.
So you're saying Turkey should get a pass because it's in a difficult neighborhood and in a difficult situation right now for violating Greek airspace, for instance?
I am saying that any nation or the airspace of all nations should be respected. NATO is not in a position where we accept any kind of violations of airspace. I'm myself coming from a nation which has seen violations of the airspace of Norway. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying that the situation along the borders of Turkey to Syria are very special. They are bordering a civil war. They have seen several violations of their airspace.
Lastly, are you worried that, as the NATO Secretary General, that Russia has transported some military equipment to Syria, it says, to protect its jet over Syrian airspace? And we're now hearing the Russian Air Force says that air-to-air missiles carried by Russian bombers have been are going to be used for, quote, self-defense. This doesn't sound at all like a situation that's de-escalating. How concerned are you?
We are concerned about the strong Russian military buildup in Syria and in the eastern Mediterranean. And the incident we saw last week just underlined the reason why we are concerned. Add to that that Russia is targeting many other targets than ISIL, and they are doing a lot of airstrikes in areas which are not at all controlled by ISIL.
The same can be said for Turkey, Secretary General. They are targeting forces that are Kurdish militants fighting ISIL as well. So you could make the same case for that country.
So any nation has the right to defend itself against terrorist attacks, and Turkey has suffered several terrorist attacks over several years. At the same time, I think we also need a political solution, a political dialogue when it comes to the challenges we see with the Kurdish population in Turkey.